new album is called Aphrodisia, right? And the story is that, you know, UNESCO has me as an artist for peace. UNESCO is basically the goodwill arm of the United Nations, right? And they're really about promoting peace. And in addition to being an artist for peace, they asked me to be the spokesperson for a project called the Slave Roots Project, right? Basically, the goal is to raise awareness of slavery. You'd be amazed, you know, the story gets a little bit more cloudy for young people. They don't really know. They know something happened, you know, but we've worked so hard to get past it that, you know, we did a good job, and now young people don't really know what happened, and that's dangerous too. So I'm looking into the slavery thing, man, and I'm following, you know, the story. And of course, you know, for African American, it starts in Africa, West Africa, you know. So I went there and I got really intrigued by the music, you know, the music, the connection. Like, I'd hear something in Mali that sounded like the blues in Louisiana, you know. I'd hear something in Cameroon that reminded me of something I heard in Brazil, you know. And I realized that this music has traveled all, you know, through this route of slavery, you know. So I decided, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to do, for my next album, I'm going to collaborate with musicians from different points along this route, right? So I did a collaboration with some musicians from Ghana and from Mali, and I collaborated with some musicians from Brazil and from the Caribbean, and also some musicians from, you know, the Delta region, you know, Louisiana. Just because I think there's such a through line, I thought it'd be very interesting. So I call the album Aphrodisia. In Morocco, right? And we played a festival celebrating Kanawa music. We went to this festival in Morocco, and we did a jam session with the Kanawa musicians, and it was beautiful, man. I'm sitting there like this, nose to nose with the guy, with the Moroccan guy, who's looking back at me, playing his, it's called a gimbri. He's playing his gimbri, and we're slapping the thing, man. It's very rhythmic, and it made me realize this is the ancestor to the instrument that I play, you know, and so many things like that. There's rhythms that they play in Kanawa music, that they play in Mali, and then you hear it in Brazil also, you know, in the samba. So I became fascinated with the connection between, you know, Africa and South America and the Caribbean, you know, because the calypso beat has the same thing, you know, in the Caribbean. And so this was my journey. I really enjoyed it, you know, really excited. And like I said, the music has so much joy. Our music is that it's instrumental. So there's no word barrier, there's no language barrier in terms of words, you know? With music, it's so honest, you know? And we play emotions, you know? We're trying to bring out emotions, and they're emotions that everybody feels, no matter where they're from, you know what I mean? So, you know, if we get that joyful thing going, man, it doesn't matter if we're in Japan or we're in Sofia, you know, Bulgaria, it doesn't matter, man. We're just like, they feel it, you know? And I think that's why UNESCO has us, you know, working, because that's what they want to do, be able to communicate. I traveled all around, you know what I mean? I have some great African musicians. We were in Brazil, we did a gig in Rio. And after the gig, you know, 1 o'clock in the morning, we went to a studio in Rio and recorded couple of songs. You know, we were in Louisiana, you know, in the Caribbean. So it's a fantastic experience.